Hey, girls, come and look! All our friends are here to see us!
They are? Oh, good, we're gonna have some fun!
We sure are! Which fairy tale will we be in today?
We'll just have to wait and see!
Hey, kids, wanna watch us go on a new adventure?
Yay!
Wow, I guess our friends really like it when we go into fairy tales!
Of course they do, and they laugh at all the tricks the witch plays!
Hey, kids, tell us something! Who are your favorite little girls?
The Triplets!
That's right, the Triplets!
Stay right there, because there's plenty of fun coming your way!
What are we waiting for?
Let's get started!
Okay!
We're too late to see Ulysses the killer whale do his show.
Aww. Bummer.
Oh, well, we'll come back another day. Who wants ice cream?
I do.
Very well, then. Ice cream for everyone. We'll go get it.
You wait here. We'll be right back.
Okie dokie.
Too bad, isn't it? I was looking forward to seeing Ulysses. Hey, it's not locked.
Does that mean we're allowed to go in?
I don't see why we shouldn't be.
I'd rather wait for the ice cream.
Hey!
Okay!
This is where they do the show.
Look at that water.
It's hot today, isn't it?
Yeah, what is it?
Exactly, Annie. You read my mind. Last banana's about an egg.
Looks like the Triplets are up to their usual mischief.
Shoes off.
No! This is not funny! Just what do they think they're doing?
Great! It sure is! The bored witch!
And who gave you permission to swim in this pool?
You want to join us?
Yeah, the water's great!
Me? Swim? Huh? Never! Huh? Hey, what's that?
It's a whale!
Hurry up!
thirsty.
Just a sec. I have to serve these girls first, all right? You're new in town, aren't you? Well, welcome to the Whale Inn. What can I do for you this evening?
We'd like a room for the night. Do you have any?
Well, you've certainly come to the right place.
She reminded me of someone, but I'm not sure who. I'm so sleepy.
My, you sure look tired. Come along, then. I'll show you to your room. Though there's just one little problem. You're going to have to share it with a sailor.
With a sailor?
Yeah, but don't worry. There are two beds, and they're pretty big.
Let's go to bed, please. All right, we'll take the room.
They're in for quite a surprise. I wouldn't miss this for the world.
This is it. Room number one. Shall we go in? Just show me the bed. Shh, Annie, quiet. Is he here? Don't think so. I don't hear anything. Well, this sounds good for me. Good night. Wait, let's take the one by the window. When the sailor comes in, chances are he'll fall into the first bed he finds. Whatever.
That's it. Giggle away.
Bed at last.
I'm getting sleepy, too. Good night, girls.
Good night.
Hey, whose chilly feet are those?
Not mine.
Not mine, either.
Then there must be a fourth pair of feet in here.
Why?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you, really. Don't worry. I'm out of here, and you can have the room.
Oh, but there's no need for you to leave. You can have one bed, and we'll take the other. I'm sure my sisters won't mind.
Of course
we're
not.
We're used to sharing, you know.
Thanks, girls. I owe you one. I've a big day ahead of me tomorrow, and I am exhausted. By the way, my name's Ismael. Sleep tight.
Good night, Ismael.
How odd. They're so quiet. Owly, put that book down and keep a watch for me, will you? Let me know if someone's coming. I'm gonna take a little peek. Shh, quiet, Owly. Hey, where is he?
Hey! What do you want in my room?
Goodness, did you hear that?
Nothing. I was just... I wanted to see if you had enough towels. I'll be off now.
I think there's someone outside the door.
And whoever it is wants to come in.
What you do here? This is my pet. Answer quick, Craig, or he be angry.
Hey, watch how you speak to my friends, all right? Be nice to them or you'll have me to deal with.
Who you? And why so many people now in my room?
I'm Ismael, harpooner, and these three are my friends.
You harpooner? Me harpooner as well.
Well then, that means we're shipmates.
Right. Huh? Shipmates never quarrel. All harpooners just like brothers. Ha ha.
Is this some kind of new dance? I think maybe it's some kind of secret handshake.
Ishmael's friends, my friends, too. I'm very happy. I make very many friends today.
What I'd like to know is, what does a harpooner do exactly?
We are part of a whale hunting team.
You guys hunt whales? Really? No kidding.
Yeah, whale hunting is really exciting, and we get to sail all over the world.
But poor whales! Thanks to you, they're now an endangered species.
What do you mean? There are lots of whales.
Listen, whales give us food and oil. We make clothes with their hide. We use the whole whale, even the bones. Anyway, we have a very big day tomorrow. Time for sleep. Good night.
What's happening tomorrow?
Tomorrow, the whaling ship sets sail, and they'll be hiring harpooners like Queequeg and me. Right. Night.
We'll see about that.
Speaking of whales.
The Pequod. Looks like a good ship. What do you think, Queequake?
Very good.
Let's go check it out. Maybe they still need harpoons.
Hey, huh?
Oh, hi there.
We've decided to go with you.
But I'm afraid whalers don't want girls on board.
Oh, yeah? Why not?
Bring very bad luck.
Bad luck? Fooey! Nonsense!
16 sailors, 4 harpooners, 2 cooks.
Hi there, Captain.
I'm very busy right now. I've got to go over this list very carefully before we leave. I'm Mr. Starbuck, the Pequod's first mate. Now, what can I do for you young ladies?
Do you need crew members? My sisters and I are expert sailors.
Right. So expert, you confuse the captain and the first mate. Anyway, I need harpooners, that's it.
Well, sir, no need to look any further.
They're gonna miss the boat, Ollie! This time I'll win for sure!
Now, girls aren't allowed on board. You'll have to stay ashore.
But...
Sorry, but we're about to set sail, and I've got lots to do. So you'll excuse me. Hey, you! Hurry up with that!
Yes, sir! We're working as fast as we can, sir!
No! You girls thinking what I'm thinking?
Queequake, I kind of miss those triplets. They were fun to hang out with, weren't they?
Yes, I miss them lots too.
I wonder where they are now. I wish I could peek through a keyhole to see them.
Ismael, what are they saying? I think Ismael remembers me.
They were so nice. Say, Queequake, why are you carving all those wooden boards?
To make a boat. Very old Polynesian tradition. Queequeg make boat to find long-lost ancestors.
Your ancestors?
Yes. If ship sinks, Queequeg get in box and look for ancestors. Queequeg don't want to end up living with fish.
All hands on deck. Captain Ahab wants to say a few words to the crew.
At last, we meet Captain Ahab.
Look lively now. I want everyone present. No exceptions. Now, I've got you all on my list here. Captain, we're ready.
Rumor has it the captain's a very strange man.
The whole crew is on deck.
All of them, sir.
Where is he?
Shh! He hasn't come out yet, you dolt.
Oh. Listen up, everyone. You see this gold coin? Huh?
Yeah!
What gold coin?
Well, first one to spot Moby Dick, the great white whale, can put it in his pocket.
Hooray!
What captain?
But Captain, according to my notes, it was the white whale's fault you lost your leg. Isn't that right?
Yes, it's Moby Dick's fault. I've got a wooden leg, and I swear I'll get my revenge once and for all. My name isn't Ahab.
Slow down there, Captain. I can't write that fast.
We'll scour the seven seas if need be, but we'll find him yet.
Yay!
You all with me, men?
Aye, aye, Captain.
So that means we're in the story of Moby Dick. That story doesn't have a very happy ending. I'll say we've got to stop him from catching the whale. Yeah, but how? Well,
All right, the triplets. How did you get on board?
Well, we've got stowaways on board.
Listen to me, Captain Ahab. You've got to call off your hunt for Moby Dick, or else the white whale will sink you and your ship, and only 2 sailors will live to tell the tale.
Just 2?
Who are you to tell me what to do? Men, grab him and throw him in the hold. I want him out of my sight. Seven, go and reassure the crew.
Aye, aye, Captain Ahab.
Now, where's my chief harpooner?
Here I am, Captain. I'll set to chase Moby Dick over the seven seas.
That's the spirit. Now let's go look at the map and try to figure out where the whale is.
Queequeg, what are you doing?
Me no sail with women. Very bad luck.
Oh, well, suit yourself. Well, girls, you got yourselves in a pretty pickle.
You got to believe us, Ismael. If we don't stop Captain Ahab, the Pequod and all its crew are doomed.
You're just saying that to scare everyone.
Please, Ismael, you've got to trust us and let us out of here. It's important.
All right, but try to make sure no one sees you or I'm in big trouble.
Ismael, you're wonderful.
Huh? Oh, Ismael, you're wonderful.
Aye, Captain. Last month, Moby Dick was heading for Whale Ocean. He must be there by now, I'm sure of it.
Then let's head for Whale Ocean. Ah, I've got you now, Moby Dick. Wretched white whale, you won't get away this time, I promise.
I suppose you know that no ship has ever returned from Whale Ocean.
No matter. We've got to catch that whale, and that's that. Set sail for Whale Ocean.
Whale Ocean? What's that? I've never heard of it, have you?
They say it's a kind of meeting place where all the whales of the world gather when it's time for them to mate, but nobody knows exactly where it is.
Then we've got to talk to Moby Dick and tell him to stay hidden.
Don't be ridiculous. You can't talk to a whale.
Of course you can. Whales are very intelligent.
And what's more, they know how to sing. They make such wonderful music.
At long last. Gotcha now, Moby Dick. Ah, Mr. Starbuck.
Aye, sir.
We'll cast anchor here. Tomorrow at daybreak, we'll start the hunt for Moby Dick.
Aye, aye, Captain. All right, everybody, cast anchor.
We've got to wait until everyone's asleep, and then we can go talk to the whales.
So, how are we going to find Moby Dick?
I'll ask around.
I can't believe...
Shh, just a sec. Listen.
What's wrong?
You hear that? Isn't it amazing? It's coming from that cove over there. Let's check it out. Oh, wow. Three female calves and their brother.
So today's the big day, huh? You're off to explore the whole wide world.
Yeah, but I'll never forget you, sis. You'll always be in my heart.
Well, son, it's time for you to go.
I know, and I'm gonna miss you lots, Mama.
Farewell, my son, farewell. It is time to strike out on your own now. Your adventure has only just begun. Though we're sad to see you go, our love goes with you. As you roam the briny ocean deep beyond you, remember, you are my son. And no matter how far away you travel, to explore all the colors of the sea, there's an undercurrent linking us forever. I will hold you in my heart, my dearest treasure. There is no near or far. There is no near or far. Is measured in love. When distance is measured in love.
Will you sing to me when I go away?
Yes, I will.
Whoa! What now? Where do all these whales come from?
From the concert we just missed?
Did you enjoy the farewell song I sang for my son?
Oh, I just loved it.
We
We're looking for Moby Dick. You know where he is?
Oh, Moby Dick's a grumpy old whale, you know. He keeps pretty much to himself. He won't want to have anything to do with you.
But it's very important that we talk to him. His life is in danger.
You'll find him near the third island, but be careful. He's got a bad temper, and he doesn't care much for visitors.
I knew it! The triplets will lead me straight to Moby Dick!
This is it.
But I don't see any sign of a great white whale.
Let's call him then.
Moby Dick! Where are you?
Hey, look!
Huh?
Oh, my gosh, it's Moby Dick!
Ah, how dare you wake me up!
Put a sock in it, you big lug. We're here to help you.
How dare you speak to me like that? I'd mind my P's and Q's if I were in your shoes.
Ishmael's right. We've come to warn you that Captain Ahab's not far from here, and he's come to get you. If I were you, I'd stay out of his way.
Ahab? Not again. Hasn't he learned his lesson yet?
You've got to get out of here.
No way. I'm staying put. If Ahab wants a fight, he'll get one. I'll send him and his ship to the bottom of the sea.
No, don't do that. Hide instead.
Hide? What do you take me for, a coward? If Ahab wants to find me, let him.
The whale is as stubborn as a mule.
We've got to get back to the Pequod before they get here.
Too late. They're already here.
Moby Dick isn't here. You lied to me.
But I saw him right here.
You fool. You let him get away. Moby Dick. Follow him! Hurry up!
What on earth ever possessed me?
Faster! Faster! This isn't your wretched whale! You can't get away! Missed him! Give me another harpoon!
There are no more! You threw the only one we
what?
Had!
Well, then, follow him!
Aye, Captain, sir! I'm coming! I'm coming! I'm going! Yeah, well, bye!
But...
I don't think we're going to be able to change the end of the story! Watch out, everybody!
Ahab!
Oh, no! Mommy!
Ahab!
No!
Uh-oh!
Having fun yet? Oh, well, too bad, because it's time to be getting going.
We'll swim ashore. It's not far. And, hey, where are you? Annie? Tessa?
Ishmael!
Queequeg!
Climb in! Me very happy now. My best friend safe and sound.
So are you. And now we're the only ones left to tell the story of Moby Dick.
Imagine being in the middle of the ocean, surrounded by dozens of whales.
Don't say that. The very thought of it makes me want to faint.
Seeing only mist in my broken crystal ball. Saying magic words which are tricky to recall. Turning into frogs that look silly as they fall. Changing into mice that are cowardly and small. Every time I try a dirty trick, it doesn't work at all.
I could be really, truly nasty, then I'd have a ball.
Being a witch is tough. It's real difficult to steer a broom. Being a witch is rough. You can't even sit in your living room. Might as well stay in bed. If you don't like getting bonked on the head, despite those pesky girls, I'd rather be a witch than anything else in the world. Try to get those triplets into a nasty scrape, a dangerous situation from which they can't escape. But everything I do seems